Y'all, I want to say thank you because I don't know what it is, but nothing is wrong. Some of y'all's emails are very thorough. I'm extremely appreciative of y'all's words, but nothing's wrong. I don't know exactly what I'll title this video, but I know like I want to shed some insight on what my father thinks about me driving trucks. And many of y'all don't know of our relationship or his perspective because I don't mention things on that level personally because I just don't, but I'll shed that. So why I did local? I started local for a reason, to take three classes outside of trucking for my own benefit, and it exceeded my own expectations. Because reason number two, I went to Grenada in high hopes to tour their St. George's Medical Campus, and it was amazing. You know, I had these aspirations for like a long time to study obstetrics, become an obstetrician, and that was life. Once I came to the realization that I did not want to do that anymore, and it is how it is. I'm gonna stick with my next plan. I'm comfortable with it. Eventually, if I feel comfortable enough to like really share what I do outside of trucking, I will, but sometimes you end up being your biggest support, you yourself. And a lot of times, some people may not want to see you elevate the way you know you're going to elevate because they can't see certain things for themselves. So that's that. Now, my father and I have a, I don't know, my dad is like, he's has like a recluse personality. So I can be aloof as well. So two people like that is like, I don't know, we don't communicate a lot, but because it's weird to even talk about it. Like it really is. You just have to like, I guess, be in our relationship to really understand. He drives trucks, and he's been driving trucks well over 10 years. It's not why I started driving trucks, but I knew that I wanted to start driving trucks because of my own benefit. I did my own research, you know, and I handled everything in my own way. When I initially told this man that I was driving trucks, he was pissed. Like, we wasn't even talking. Like, he wasn't talking to me, for real. And all I could think about was like, he's not seeing the bigger picture on why I'm doing what I'm doing for me, which was very beneficial for me, you know? As his daughter, I wanted him to be understanding of the fact, because all it takes is just clear understanding to see the end result, you know, the end goal. But with him, I guess it was other factors that went along with why he was mad, why he didn't want me out there, why he felt like I should have been focused on another area of my life and my pursuits and things like that. But he does local stuff. He's never been over the road, so he never had that experience to really shed any type of insight. All I know is this man was pissed. We wasn't talking for a period of time. And yeah. Now that I guess he's gotten to a better understanding of why I do what I do, he feels a little bit more comfortable with me driving, because he knows that I'm not gonna do anything to really jeopardize my safety or my well-being or anything like that, you know? So I'm grateful for that, because all it takes, Lord, is just understanding. It's all it takes is just understanding to really see what somebody's trying to like conjure up with whatever they're trying to pursue, you know? I don't know. I know that when we wasn't talking, it didn't bother me completely, because like, again, you have to understand our relationship to really understand what we have going on. But what I'm trying to say, well, let me just say like this. Do what you want to do for you, and don't live your life through someone else's. Don't, because I did lose someone that was pretty close not too long before I went to Grenada, and again, certain things I just keep to myself. But I will say that you, myself, we all have the opportunities to shape certain things in our own way, you know, perfect our own craft. And I'll be saying, like, tomorrow's never promised, and I'm pretty sure y'all heard it before. It's not, because sometimes we're not really prepared for things, you know, mentally, physically, emotionally, or spiritually. But you can train your mind, you can train yourself, like, internally to adapt to certain things or adopt new ideas, I guess, because if you have a clear perspective, if you have a good understanding of certain things, you won't really be defeated or feel defeated in, like, this race of life that we live. I don't know what I'm really trying to say, or I know what I'm trying to say, but I can't really, like, elaborate my thoughts to where they come out fluid. But yeah, man, like, I encourage people who aren't afraid, because fear can honestly defeat you, can limit you when it comes to pursuing different things. I encourage and motivate people to try to drive trucks or get into the industry, but do it the right way. You know, do your own research to go to a company that may be beneficial for you. Don't allow fear to really project certain things. Overcome obstacles and they